my name is Sage Foley, and I'm a designer and seamstress that works in film, fashion, and theater. Today, I wanted to sit down and talk about the exact moment in time when I decided I wanted to become a costume designer. So to start off, I went to a university in London to get my bachelor's degree, and I was studying international business. When I left high school, my goal was to become the head of international business at the BBC. I know, it's a big goal. I've always had very large goals. Also, because it's important to the story, I wanted to note that I actually graduated high school with my associate's degree in business, so I got to skip my first year of school at the university that I went to in London. So about 2 weeks into my freshman year of school, I was so bored. I found that I was taking a lot of the same classes I had taken with my associate's degree, so I wasn't feeling challenged, I wasn't really learning anything new, and I just didn't feel like I was getting anything out of my classes. So when I moved to London, basically immediately, I picked up the habit of walking around and kind of enjoying the city by myself. I used to go to a lot of museums. I used to look at all of the landmarks. I used to kind of do a lot of weird activities. I went to talks. I did art classes, lots of odd things. And I started that habit pretty early, basically as soon as I moved there. So I was doing that a lot by the time I got to this point where I had no idea on what I wanted to do with my life. So one day when I was heading home from one of my outings, I was on the underground and we pulled up to a station and there was this huge poster that had a 1700s French court gown on it. I didn't know that it was a French court gown then, I know that now. Then I just knew it was a pretty historical gown. And the words on the poster said, "Dressed by angels." I thought about this poster all the way home, so I looked it up and I saw that Angels is a family of costumers that has made and rented out costumes in the film and theater industries for I think around 120 years, if I'm remembering correctly. And basically they have worked on tons of huge films, tons of huge theater productions. And I thought that that sounded really cool to go and see. Like I said, I loved going on outings and going to kind of weird museums or interesting talks. I was kind of just doing everything. So when I saw this, I was like, oh, this is right up my alley. This is definitely something I would enjoy. I love movies. I love clothes. So let's do it. And of course, the opening day just happened to be on my day off from school. So I was like, it's perfect. It's meant to be. And my roommate, Emily, also had that day off from school, so I asked her if she wanted to go because I know she loves theater, and of course she agreed, so we planned on going. So that day we went, and we actually went right when the exhibit was supposed to be opening, and we were worried it was going to be really busy, but it wasn't. There actually wasn't a ton of people there. And so we went up, we got our tickets, the people were super excited that we were there because there wasn't a ton of people there, and we started walking through. And they had so many cool costumes. They had things from Game of Thrones, Titanic, Doctor Who, they had TV shows, they had theater, they had movies. It was really, really awesome, and it was really cool to see the costumes up close and personal. And then kind of once you got past there, they started a section of the exhibit where they were talking about the process of costuming, what it takes, kind of how it goes from script to rendering to creation and then to filming. So we're walking through the process and we get to the rendering room, which was a room covered in pictures of drawings of costumes that you've loved in every movie ever. So think of any costume that you've loved in a movie, or a theater production, or a TV show. It was in drawing form on the wall of that room. There were some costumes from some of my favorite movies, and suddenly there was just this click in my brain. I honestly can't describe it as anything else. Some people might call it an epiphany. I call it this just extreme moment of clarity. You know when you just know something in your bones, like you just know something is true? Well, in that moment, I knew that this was what I wanted to do. I had never made the connection in my head that somebody has to design the costume piece that's in the scene that evokes so much emotion and makes you laugh or makes you cry or makes you feel happy. Somebody has to design the costumes that are in the movies that make you feel nostalgic, the movies from your childhood. And so I just thought, what an interesting way that fashion gets to be a part of everybody's lives. Of course, fashion is already a part of everybody's lives because we wear clothes every single day, but like, movies have such sentimental value to us as people. And this is also, of course, true for theater and TV shows. Don't think I'm leaving those out. But it was just this moment where I was like, I want to do that. I knew I didn't want to do business anymore. I knew I needed to make a change. And in this moment, the universe was like, here you go. I did actually keep the ticket from that exhibit. So I do actually have a tangible object of the exact moment when my life changed. Because truly, I don't mean that in little terms. If I would have never gone to school where I'm into school, I would have never seen that poster, and I would have never found that exhibit, I would have never gone to that exhibit, and I would have never had that moment, and I wouldn't be sitting in an LA apartment making this video right now. I wouldn't have had any of the experiences I've been so blessed to have. I wouldn't have met any of the people that I've met through my work. I wouldn't have gone to Paris Fashion Week. I wouldn't have worked at operas, and I wouldn't have worked on Broadway shows, and I wouldn't have worked in LA doing anything I've done if it wasn't for that moment. So I knew I wanted to be a costume designer, so I literally, from the second I got back to my dorm that very day, I hit the ground running, changing everything. I had to talk to course leaders to switch to the film course. I had to get permission to join the film course from their course leader. I had to get permission to leave my course from the business course leader. And he was the first person to express extreme doubt in my plan. He was like, you want to leave the business course to study film so you can be a costume designer? And I was like, yes. And he was like, that seems like a bad idea. And I was like, I could see why you would think that. And he was like, so are you sure? But I looked at him and I have said, probably the most confidently I've ever said anything in my life, I was like, I have never been more sure about anything before. And so he signed the paper, and next thing I knew, I was in film class, and I had 2 weeks and a year to catch up to catch up with, because like I said, I skipped my first year, so I went into school as a second year, and the film department let me in also as a second year, even though I literally knew nothing about film. I didn't know any of the terminology, I didn't know any of the history, I didn't know anything about film. So I went to the bookstore and I literally got Filmmaking for Dummies and I read the entire thing, and I had to catch up with my coursework, and I did it. And I graduated top of my class. Part of the reason why I'm telling this story is because when I was still in the business course, before I had any of this realization, before I knew I wanted to change, I was actively trying to get internships in the business field. I was trying to beef up my resume so that when I graduated, I could get a good job. And I applied for so many things, so many internships, so many like student work programs, and I got nothing. I wouldn't hear back, or if I did hear back, if I got an interview, they would meet me and they would say, sorry, we're not bringing you on. And that really brought me down. And I was like, why is this happening? And then I switched, and along with switching my courses, I also immediately started looking for opportunities in costumes. So I found a regional theater called the Tower Theater Company in London, and I sent them an email, and I was like, I have no experience, but I really want to do this, and I really want to learn. And so I would love to assist one of your designers on an upcoming show if you guys don't mind, or if you need the help. And I immediately heard back, and I was in that same week working as an assistant to their designer. And that was my first time ever working on a theater production at all. And that's where I learned so many things. The reason I'm saying that is because truly, I think that the people in business could see that I didn't really want to be there. I wasn't that passionate about it. At the time, I didn't necessarily know I didn't want to be there, but I didn't want to be there. And I think that there's something to be said about, if you're meant to be doing something, doors are going to open. People are going to see your passion. They're going to see your light. They're going to see your spark. And they're going to want you to be there. And they're going to want you to be doing the work. But I'm also telling the story because I think sometimes the universe tries in so many different ways to tell you something. I was always a creative person. I always loved fashion. So why did I choose a career that was so not creative? I chose a business career. And I wanted to do work behind a desk my entire life. And finally, the universe had to literally grab me and shake me and say, no, you're going to do this and you're going to like it so much more. Thank you guys so much for watching and listening to this story. I wasn't on script at all for this story. This was all completely stream of consciousness. So if it was rambling, I apologize. If it wasn't organized, I apologize. My past couple videos have been on script because I feel like I need to make sure I get all of the information in. And because I'm new to YouTube, so right now I'm a little uncomfortable with it, especially the talking to the camera part. But after this video, I think I'm gonna move a little bit off script for all of my videos. I really want you guys to see who I am and my personality. So thank you guys so much for bearing with all of the growing pains of this channel. It's just getting started and there's a lot to do and there's a long way to go, but I'm excited for it and I think it's gonna be great. So I hope you guys keep watching, and until then, you guys can follow me on Instagram and TikTok at FullDressed, and I'll see you guys soon.